It's great to be able to add the voice of City Lights books to praise you and your new book, Beyond the Possible. To tell the truth, I'm awed by what you have done in 50 years at a community called Glide. You have gone so far beyond the possible. To attend the celebration at Glide Memorial is to experience a kind of revolutionary euphoria, the good part of many revolutions, such as I experienced in the early days of the Fidelista and Sandinista regimes, a feeling of liberation and pure joy. And here's my poem, first published in The Nation magazine, at a time when the revolutionary ideas of Occupy was just being born. And this is the poem of Lawrence Ferlenghetti. And then I'll read my own. It's called The First and the Last of Everything. The first cry of man in the first light, the first firefly flickering at night, the first song of love and 40 cries of despair, the first voyage of Vikings westward, the first sighting of the new world from the crow's nest of a Spanish galleon, the first pale face meeting the first Native American, the first Dutch trader in Manhattan, the first settler on the first frontier, the first home sweet home so dear, the first wagon train westward, the first sighting of the Pacific by Lewis and Clark, the first cry of Mark Twain on the Mississippi, the first desegregation by Huck and Jim on a raft at night, the first buffalo head nickel and the last buffalo, the first barbed wire fence and the last of the open range, the last cowboy on the last frontier, the first skyscraper in America, the first home run hit at Yankee Stadium, the first ballpark hot dog with mustard, the last war to end all wars, the last wobbly and the last Catholic anarchist, the last living member of the Abraham Lincoln Brigade, the last Bohemian in a beret, the last homespun politician in the first stolen election, the first plane to hit the first Twin Tower, the birth of a vast national paranoia, the first president to become an international criminal for crimes against humanity, making America a terrorist state, the dark dawn of American corporate fascism, the next to last free speech radio, the next to last independent newspaper raising hell, the next to last independent bookstore with a mind of its own, the next to last lefty looking for Obama Nirvana, the first fine day of the Wall Street occupation.